How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Dead Space. I'm Greg, aka Gr3g1zard, from Poker Room Gr3g1zard Gaming on YouTube. And, yeah, we're playing this shit on an impossible mode because we're masochists and we hate ourselves and we want to hurt ourselves. But yeah, I hope everybody's liking this. I hope everybody likes, you know, enjoying, they like to see me play this game. It's one of my favorite games. Like, if I had to say, like, my top favorite games that I like to play, Dead Space 1, definitely one of them. I like Legend of Zelda a lot. I like Skyrim. Fallout, yeah. I like the new Fallout games. I played the old Fallout games too, which were, you know, primitive in their own way, but still pretty good. Definitely a different game. But yeah, Mass Effect. I can't wait for the new Mass Effect game to come out. I'm super excited about that. Just like, you know, the humans, you know, the Alliance or whatever is in a whole new galaxy. You know, there's new aliens, you know, new shit to blow up. But yeah, like, I like games where you can actually, like, you can explore freely. Like, this game, you can kind of do that. I mean, it's pretty linear. Dead Space is pretty linear. Like, you have a set thing that you're supposed to do, and usually if you don't do that, you die. But yeah, like games that you get to explore and you get to do other things, I like those games. Because you can kind of lose yourself, you know, like in a world where you can do almost anything. I mean, like, so Minecraft was pretty much, I know I'm going off on a tangent. Minecraft was kind of one of those games that started it all for a lot of people. I can go anywhere in the world and I can make all these things if I just try hard enough and I go exploring enough. Like, yeah, dude, those games are awesome. Those are the games you want to play. Games that keep you coming back because it's not the same story or the same environment. Just, you know, recycled until you get sick of it. Like, yeah. So I'm sure, like, there's some people who play, you know, Zelda Ocarina of Time and are just like, it's totally a different game every time I play. It's not like you're set on a course where you have to do a specific thing. But yes, you can run around, do side quests, all that good stuff. I think every game, even if it's not a RPG, should have side missions. You know, little things that you can do that aren't directly tied to the main game or the story. I mean, I guess achievements are like one way of doing that, where you go out of your way while you're playing the game to be like, oh, I bet I can get this, you know, achievement for doing this specific thing.
And power failure.
And it's all how you want to play the game, right?
Is that it? You got it? Oh my god! You got it! That's the piece we need. Get to the crew deck.
Oh, Kendra. Oh, poor Hammond. This is Hammond. Remember Hammond, everybody?
You got the singularity core, that's our ticket out of here. Get that core, Mr. Don't wait for me! Oh, fuck me!
Dude doesn't have a stasis module doesn't have the fucking kinesis module. Oh, I guess it's leg ripped off. I missed him! You killed my friend! I'll never forget you! Round. Leg. Yeah, how you like that shit? Asshole, you killed my buddy. He was my only friend.
I just lost all of Hammond's vitals. Is he dead? Oh god. I just lost now, Isaac.
Warning. Yeah, just like a failure of I wanted to just not include Hammond where you could just literally fuck with me and there's not a second person like telling me the right thing to do. That's what Hammond was doing.
Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
I wouldn't be surprised if Kendra had something to do with Hammond dying. Like right there. Right?
Warning. Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
I mean, he was killed by a necromorph. But like maybe she opened some doors for the necromorph to get to him to kill him? Because I'm sure at some point she realized, like, oh shit, Hammond's actually helping me. And I need to make sure that this happens so I can get Isaac to do what I want. So, yeah, she's a conniving bitch. But, you know, we'll forgive her for that. Holy shit. Look at this shit. Just everything's exploding. Let's take one last look at the USM Valor. There it is. Just crashed into the USG Ishimura. Just blowing the fuck up. Gotta say, I'm playing this on impossible mode. Maybe it's because I've played the game before, but it's not that impossible. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I've played the game before quite a few times. I know where I'm going most of the time. You know, it's still a fun game. Like, it hasn't got repetitive. I guess that's how you judge, like, a game's lifespan, is if you can actually play the game without getting pissed off, like, oh my god, I'm doing the same thing I've done in this game so many times. But yeah, like, I enjoy playing this game, like, almost every time I pick it up, whether I take like a, whether it's like a year or a month or a week, it's still fun every time I play it. Yeah, it's linear. I know where I'm going. Maybe that's why it's okay, you know? To me, at least. Because I can literally, like, take a couple years from playing this game, pick it back up again, and I know exactly where I'm going. It's the whole familiarity.
Isaac, I located the shuttle Hammond found. Shit. No good. That shuttle's brain dead. Someone removed the navigation cards. God knows why. There's three of them scattered around the deck. I'm downloading their locations. I can't access the doors from here, so you'll need a crew key. If you can find those parts, I think we can get that shuttle operational again.
Okay, so need to get some kind of fucking key for the thingamabob. But I just want everybody to check this shit out. Like, Right, that's a symbol of the marker. It's also a symbol of unitology. All these people have, like, rags or something over their heads with holes in their foreheads. Now, did they do that themselves? Did somebody do it to them? Did they agree to this? Who knows, right? But the reason I'm stomping on these poor innocent bodies of people is because... that's funny. Get off me! There's a part later in the game where those things that turn people into necromorphs, they get to this room and see all the dead bodies and just go fucking ape shit and just start turning everything into a necromorph. So, if I dismember them by stomping on them before that happens, I'm pretty sure they can't turn into necromorphs. Or they do, but... You know what? I don't know why I even do that. Because it's just some theory that I've had in my head for years. Like, no, like, yeah, just stomp on the body parts and stomp on their limbs and they'll come back as just... I don't know. I just think that that's what's a good idea to do. So I always do it every time I play the game. I need pulse rounds. And I need health. I'm gonna try to spend as little time in the store as possible, because I know it's not exactly, it's not exactly entertaining just to watch somebody buy shit. So, I gotta go up the elevator, but I see a thing over here. Okay. That's about it. You know what? If a necromorph wants to turn a bunch of other these, you know, poor people into necromorphs, have at it. I've got more than enough ammo to take care of whatever thing wants to kill me. United we ascend? Is Unitology a new hope or just another scam? By Carrie Van Otken. If you've been living on Mars for the past 200 years, you might have missed the fast-growing religious movement in history. The fastest-growing. Unitology boasts a following of millions, counts powerful CEOs and officials in its ranks, claims $78 billion of stock in multi-global companies, and owns two of the Earth's largest financial institutions. From its beginnings as a cult of personality, Unitology has become a respected, established religion. Most people know the basics. 200 years ago, Michael Altman, a professor of anthropology, blew the whistle on what he claimed was the biggest cover-up ever instituted by Earth government, the discovery of an artifact or marker which proved beyond any doubt that there is alien life in the universe. The government labeled Altman a kook, but his claims struck a chord with some, and his mysterious death soon afterwards fueled that interest. Unitologists believe that the marker contained a code, the key to eternal life, through rebirth and ascension to heaven. The kicker is you have to die first. They say the government is hiding the marker somewhere, keeping its secrets for themselves. Across all of human space, Unitologists praise Altman's martyrdom and await the day God comes to take them to their new life beyond death. It all sounds pretty harmless, but like any other cult, there's a dark side. Unitologists are ranked in the church. Nobody ever talks about it, but most of its critics believe that there are at least three ranks above the average believer, or initiate. With each new rank, more of the church's inner workings and research is revealed to a follower, and these ranks are achieved by one simple criteria: giving money and power to the church. Just like any other religion. Think taking all your money's bad? The church also requires members to donate their bodies after death. Why? What do they do with them? Nobody will say. And attempts to infiltrate the inner circle have failed. with their emphasis on transformation and rebirth, maybe we wouldn't like the answer even if they told us. One rumor that also refuses to die says the church is funding a secret shipbuilding program. Some claim to have seen the fleet. No documentary evidence has been supplied, but the claimants all say that these mausoleum ships, despite they, yeah, huge size. So the ship that we're on, the USG Ishimura, one of the first ever documented biggest planet cracker ships, as far as, you know, this universe and this game goes. It's one of the biggest ships that was ever made. So they were talking about mausoleum ships. Ships to hold artifacts, like temples. And that's what the ship is.
What do you cling to when all must seem so utterly hopeless around you? Dr. Cross was a true believer. She had faith. And now she awaits her transformation, her rebirth. Are you ready to ascend, Mr. Temple?
Mrs. Temple.
Of course you are. Have no fear. You will play your part soon enough. Witness the conviction of a true believer! They are ready. Take them. Embrace them.
And then he's walking over there now. So Temple, that was the guy that was leaving those audio files for us to listen to. He was trying to find Elizabeth from hydroponics, get both of them off the ship, but didn't work out like that. Didn't go well, as you can see. Man, that Mercer guy. That guy who just killed Temple. He's a real big fucking asshole. I'm pretty sure, like, he knows exactly what's going on. People are being killed, and then the dead people are coming back as necromorphs, or blah blah blah, transformed, something. That's probably Elizabeth right there. Elizabeth Cross. So he's a scientist, and then he gets turned into, like, a religious nutbag. It doesn't happen very often, like, anywhere. In any video game, in any movie, and in real life. You don't see Bill Nye the Science Guy going to, like, you know, the Noah's Ark Museum or something, like, you know? I'm starting to believe. Like, no. Scientists believe in science. And that's it. Doesn't mean that they're wrong. Doesn't mean that, you know, organized religion is necessarily wrong. Just means that they don't need a book to do something. They need evidence. Hard fucking evidence. Not to shit on anybody's religion or anything, but, you know. I mean, if you're thinking one thing your whole life, and that's the truth, like, that's what you know is the truth. But then something else comes along, and he's like, hey, I know you believe in that one thing, but here's another side of it. Don't be the person that's just like, you know what? I'm not going to listen to anything you have to say because I know I'm right. Like, you got to be open-minded. Like, in everything in life, you have to be open-minded. Because, I mean, you could learn something that might change your whole life. Just by not being closed-minded. And I think that's pretty important. Sorry to get so serious. But yeah, just make your own decisions, come up with your own conclusions, don't believe exactly
Mr. Clark,
what everybody else tells you.
I really must speak with you. I'm very close to your position, and I know you want to hear what I have to say. I can explain all this. So what happened? When you have the nav cards, I'll let you into the security station. We must talk. Hurry!
That's Dr. Kime. Get him? It's hard to aim this. Oh shit! Back! Back, demon! So many hits. Alright, I got health. I'm gonna definitely use my health. Heal thyself, brother. So yeah, if anybody cares, we have Pokeroo and Gr3g1zard Gaming. Just did a couple episodes, they might not be up yet, but they will be eventually, of Dead Space 3. And I wish that me and Justin could have played together, like, cooperatively. But we just don't have the technology right now. Like, I don't have a computer, he's got a computer. I've been playing console games and, you know, that's all I can play right now. But that's one of the games that I do want to show on the channel. Because it's not as bad as we make it look to be, you know? I mean, we make fun of the game and how there's just too many confusing things about it. Like, how do you make guns that actually work, and where do you find all the blueprints? It's like, that's gonna happen in time. And I went apparently backwards, I guess. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? I just came from here. Yeah, this is the goopy floor. I can't run on the goopy floor. I was literally just fucking there. Why am I going back? Anyways, so when you're walking on this shit, you can't run. Which kind of sucks. Alright. Did I literally forget to just go in here? Yeah, I did. See ya, buddy. Cue the elevator music. I have so many credits in this game. It's not even funny, bro.
The life support system in Sleep Block B has been shut down. You'll have to find an override nearby to get through the door.
Oh my god. I just realized I was a necromorph and he didn't even stand up. I have a fucking table attached to me right now. Is anyone seeing this? I have a fucking table attached to my fucking thorax. Look at this shit! Like, get off me! My god. I had a table attached to my... Oh no, no, no. Oh no, not the tentacle again. Some of you might be thinking, why? Why is this kind of attack like three different times? Well, One more second, I would have been dead. Yeah, so the tentacle that just grabbed me is part of, you know, obviously, if you haven't figured it out, a larger enemy. At the end of the game, tries to kill you. It's not the enemy that we shot with the ADS cannon, the asteroid destroying cannon. It's not the same enemy. That was Leviathan. This is called the Hive Mind. So it's really fucking big. Its tentacles can reach basically anywhere. Yeah. Or maybe it's just a tentacle. I mean, it could be just a tentacle. Right? Not attached to anything. So what did this do? Door lock overridden. Okay. So I gotta go through a door. Your health. Yeah, thanks, dude. Thanks, bro. Not sure if it's gonna happen now.
Life support and climate system malfunction.
Yeah.
Hazardous condition. Please contact repair specialist. Entering GR3g.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering, because this room looks like the other room that I was just in, except it's all different looking. It's brighter in here, and there's no oxygen. Okay. Got all the things. Running out of oxygen. I think there's an oxygen right here. It's gotta beat this fucking guy first.
Life support and climate system malfunction. Hazardous condition. Please contact repair specialist.
I'm supposed to go this way. Alright, never mind. So yeah, like, you press a button and it's just like, you have to go this way. But you don't have to. You know what I mean? Like, you can go explore if you want. So I think it told me to go this way, right? But then I went out here, and it's just like, it told me to go a different way. Either way, doesn't really matter. Just gonna try to get through this part as quickly as possible without dying too much.
Life support and
fucking
climate system malfunction. Hazardous condition. Please contact repair specialist.
Okay, I am currently running out of air. Got another table stuck to me. Alright. I gotta get past this part. Pretty sure there's gonna be spiders that jump out of him. How did I get hurt? He didn't even hit me. Okay then, guess I'm not gonna worry about that. God, I hope I don't fucking run out of air. That'd be literally the worst way to die in Dead Space, is just to run out of air.
Hazardous condition. Please contact repair specialist.
So I can go through here. I don't know why I'm doing this. I'm literally wasting my air right now. But items, though. Oh, gasping for air. Alright, this should bring me to the main room, which does have an air oxygen refill station somewhere. If I can fucking find it. Oh, it's right here. Sweet deal.
Life support and climate system malfunction. Exiting vacuum.
Can't see anything. Just to make sure I'm going through the right door, you know. Gotta press the button. Alright, we're gonna get, hopefully, to a save point, and then end the episode, and then I will be playing Resident Evil 7 after this. So if anybody cares to watch, that's what I'll be doing. Yeah. No, come on, there is a save station out here, isn't there? No? Gotta go all the way back? Shit, dude. Oh, this is where the fucking guys threw out. And I can't run. Boom. Oh fuck, 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 fuck. This is what I hate, you can't run. You can't run on these fucking goopy floors. Shit, shit, dude. Just get away from me. I don't want no trouble, man. Men. Things. Eat shit. Alright. So, hopefully we'll get through the chapter 10 in the next, episode of Dead Space. I'm Greg, aka Gr3g1zard, and, I'll see you all next time. See you later!